Okay. Hey, you guys, you weren't ready. Hi. Hello. Hi, everyone. It's Rita and Teddy Bear and Benji here today. Hi, Sherry. This is going to be a really exciting and info-packed show because I have so much to tell you. There's so much going on. Plus, I want to talk about my schedule and also this project, which if you've been following me for more than a year, you know I did this last year, but I have got some changes that I want to show you. Lots of stuff. But first, let's start with, oh my God, it's finally fall here. It's nice and cool. I have to wear a sweater and it's so awesome. Owen has the day off today. He's going to go into Salem he wants to go to the Witch Museum, which I think is a new thing. I tried to get him to go to PVD, the PEM. It's called PVD Essex Museum, which is in Salem. But he says it's a little too highbrow for him. So, also last night I got a chance to see Lola. She is looking great. Mom loves her. She loves Mom, and everybody in Mom's, care facility there just love her. The only thing she complained about was, how much she sheds. And I'm like, welcome to the world of corgis. Hi, Bailey's mom, Sarah. So welcome. I have so much to share with you today. I almost don't even know like where to start. I did make notes. Oh my gosh, look at all my notes. Let's start off from the top, and that is that we are in the last few days of our October giveaway, which is a Cricut mug press plus $50 worth of infusible ink for a total of $250. This is not a little prize, folks. $250 prize that you could win just by following me. And remember, if you're following me on YouTube, but you also have a Facebook page, you can follow me on Facebook, and that gets you another entry. And I love seeing all the comments and the shares. And that really, really helps me. I'm so bound and determined to get to 20,000 subscribers on YouTube by the end of the year. Can you help me with that? I really, really would appreciate it. It's for me, it's just a personal goal. There's nothing in it, like in terms of, I make more money and everything, or it's not like that at all. It's just a personal goal that after 2 years of basically going live every day and posting on YouTube, I have 20,000 people that think I'm phenomenal. And that is an exciting thought. So I know you all think I'm phenomenal anyway, but good morning. So the last few days for this giveaway for the mug press, you need to look in the description of the video. If you can't find it, just look a little bit harder. If you're looking from your mobile phone, you have to use that little down arrow on YouTube to see the description, okay? And then you'd click through after you've liked and commented and done all that stuff. You click through on the Rafflecopter link, and then when you go to the Rafflecopter link, you just have to put in, you check the boxes off, and you put in your name and your email address. I am not going to use the email address for anything other than talking to you about being a potential winner, so don't worry about that. somebody doesn't think I'm phenomenal. I just got an angry face. Come on, don't be angry facing me. I am really up and so excited today. I'm so excited today. So if the angry face was accidental, that's okay. I know everybody makes mistakes. Okay. So, the other thing, someone just brought it up. The other thing is yesterday's project, which was the twist pop card from Friday night. The file is corrupt and I have to redo it. I am going to repost it on the original video, and I'll also repost it in a post on YouTube and a post on Facebook. I apologize. I did have the dev team look at it. I haven't heard back from them. So I'm just going to recreate it and repost it for you. So I apologize for that. And thank you, Teresa. I am fabulous. We're all fabulous. Isn't it great? So don't worry. It's coming. And I know you guys want to do it. And it was just a corrupt file. The third thing is, the reason why, maybe why this happened, was they're installing a brand new update. So if you haven't got it yet, you are going to get it. And you will not believe what's in this update for Design Space, okay? In Design Space, if you got the update, you can see, if you want to see what's new, by the way, you can come right up here. See these three little lines, often called the hamburger? Can you see it? These three little lines? It's often called the hamburger. If you click on that and you go to what's new, about three quarters of the way down, it's going to give you sort of a rolling inventory of all the new things in Design Space. So background remover for images, which a lot of us already have gotten, is part of this 6.15 release of Design Space. There's also featured images on the homepage where you can see new and regularly refreshed images from the Cricut library. Then, oh my gosh, I totally love this. And it's not highlighted enough, but you can now save images to view later. Now, has this happened to you? Because it's happened to me. Like, I've been going through images and I'm looking for something. Let's say I'm looking for something, candy corn. All right. So I put in candy corn. This is a real life example. So when I do the candy corn, I am going to be using this image right here. So that's what I came for. But as I scroll, I remember that I have a file over here that's Laurie Whitlock's little like handbag, handle box for candy corn. And I also have this one here, this cutesy girl wearing a candy corn costume that has a card that goes with it. And I have a bad memory. I'm not going to remember that those things are there. So what I can do is I can save them. There's a little thing. It looks like a bookmark. And that's what it is. It's a bookmark. You're just going to go and click on that. And that way, when you can do up to 1,000 images. This is good for people like me that have some issues with memory. And so you can go and say I do this all the time. I just scroll through images. Whenever somebody says to me, oh, access is not worth it, that's when I start scrolling through images and I'm like, oh, really? Oh, really? Access is an image isn't worth it? Look at this. Look at this. Look at this. And now I can do that. Like, I love this trick-or-treat one. I'm going to save it. I'm going to put it on a bag. Actually, there are four different kinds here. So what you could do is you can use the triple dots and you can view the image set as well. Because that's fun too, to see all the images that might be associated with that. And here you can indeed, still bookmark here. So this is a fabulous thing. And then when you want to go back and look at your saved, this is where you would do it, right here at saved. Okay. So let's see. That is with all of the changes. I think we might need to have a little episode where we talk about the new changes, including the photo background removal, because I did use it and it was awesome. I finally got it. Okay. Okay. The schedule is packed. this week. So if you've been following along, I have been actually creating ahead of time the schedule on Facebook in events. So if you're following me and if you're following me, you will get a notification in events. Okay. So coming after today, today's the candy corn banner, but tomorrow is Christmas Day, and we are doing a beautiful card from Robin Bob. Why is somebody giving me angry? Oh, whatever. And we're doing this card, Warm Winter Wishes. You know, if you don't like what you're hearing, just get off because nobody cares. Hi, Paralita. So we're doing this great card on tomorrow because it's Christmas Day. Then we have Friday. It's our Freebie Friday. We're doing a card from Dreaming Tree. So go ahead and get that by going to 3dsvg.com. Maybe they're upset about the design space things. Who cares? I don't know. You know, I just, these people are passive aggressive, so whatever. So anyway, go to Free SVG Files and pick up this Gobble Gobble Turkey with the matching envelope. And we're going to do that on Friday. And then on Saturday, let's go on over to Saturday. Saturday, we are going to do Lori Whitlock's Haunted House. So we have Christmas tomorrow, Thanksgiving on Friday, and Halloween on Saturday. Come on, that's just like so many holidays rolled into one. Let me just show you where you can pick up, if you want, where you can pick up these awesome files from Lori Whitlock. You'd go to 3D Houses and her most recent houses. What's going on? Houses. Well, it's here. It's under 3D Houses, and they're Lori Whitlock's, I don't know, guys. The internet is not being kind to me today. So whatever. Okay. Yeah, they might have. Who cares? I don't really care. If you give me an angry face, it's not going to change me and what I'm doing here because I get so many happy faces and lovey-doveys that an angry face here or there is not going to deter me from doing what I do every day. People like this, okay? So maybe you don't. And maybe this just isn't the place for you, and that's okay. So here's the, and that's all I'm going to say about it. So here's the large haunted house bundle, which you can buy all three. I'm going to attempt to make all three. But if you want, you can also buy these individually. She also has, she's doing these 3D houses. And I kind of like, wondering if I should buy these for our tiered tray because they're kind of small enough that I could put them on the tray. But maybe I'll just buy one of them. Anyway, she has them for almost every holiday. So you can get them by going to shop.loriwhitlock.com. Okay? The other thing I want to mention is I went to Craft Direct and I got a huge haul of paper from them, and I'm going to do a haul video, just like a really informal one later on today, which I will then post to YouTube. I just wanted to show you some of the Doodlebug kits that I got. So beautiful. I also picked up some paper from Michaels that they had on sale. Buy one, get two free, and I'll show you those as well. So we'll do that separately, okay? All right, let's get down to business. We're going to talk about this banner. Now, if you've been with me for a while, you may have said, Rita, we did this banner last year. Why are you showing us old things? Well, sometimes you like to come back to projects and sort of make changes. And that's what I did here. When I first showed you this project, it did not have the holes in the candy corns for the banner. So, I used a hole punch, and I believe it was Regina who said to me, why are you using a hole punch? Why don't you just have the machine cut the circles? And I was like, that's a brilliant idea. So when I went to redo this, I added the holes, and I'm going to show you where I got them. First, I was going to add them myself, but I found the same image with the holes in there, and that's great. I also decided to cut the backing of this on craft paper. So this is the backing, and the first time I did it, I cut it out in paper, but what ended up happening is this bottom part here was really flimsy because we had 2 and 3, right? And so I decided to cut just the white part out from craft board, and then I cut these out from paper, okay? And then it creates a very sturdy banner, and then I'm going to show you how that goes together. Also, I want to show you how I got the trick or treat image. This is an image from Design Space, so it's completely easy to get, and I'm going to show you how I changed it around. And what's the third thing I did? Oh, I miniaturized it. So this was the original size, and I miniaturized it for our tiered tray that's coming up, and let me just show you what that looks like. Look, is it a cute trick, or... I put them on separate things because I thought they could go on the different layers. Trick or treat! So cute. And yes, if you're looking at this for the first time, yes, I did use vinyl for the letters on this. I did that last year as well. So let's get into the finding and creating this file. Okay, so as I mentioned, so I'm going to save this. And I'm going to start new so you can see if you cannot get my file, you can go and recreate it yourself. So I'm going to start with a blank screen and I'm going to go, oh yeah, trick or trunk. That's a good idea too. I'm going to go to images, okay, which is my favorite place. And I am going to look for candy corn just like I did before. And I'm going to find... Oops, I typed in Andy Corn. Candy corn. What am I talking about? Let's do that again. Oh, yeah. What? Come on, candy corn. I'll ask it again. Why? Try it this way. Candy corn. And it's not working. Let me get out of here and go back. Candy corn. Oh, there it is. Okay. So you will notice this is my original thing that I used. And this is the one I used for this time around. You see, it has the holes and not that it matters, but it's upside down. It matters when you put it together, obviously, but this is the one I want. So just grab one and we'll duplicate it in the end. All right. So we add it to the canvas. Now we'll go back. And we're going to look at images. Did it add? No. We're going to go back to images and we're going to look for something that says trick or treat. Trick or treat. And I'm going to show you what I used. I think it's an old Teresa Collins. Do you remember Teresa Collins? She was a designer. I don't know if she still designs for Cricut, but this was a designer. So this is the image I'm going to use. It has a bat on it. I'm going to show you how to get rid of the bat. Okay, so we're going to pull that in along with our candy corn. So the candy corn's really big. We'll just leave it big. We'll put it over here. And we'll just work on this, and then we'll change it out. So I don't like the bat. So I want to get rid of the bat. Plus, I want to make the or smaller so that I can put it on one candy corn, okay? So I am going to, and because it's all one color, it's one solid color, there's no layers to it, I can't really use contour because if I use contour, it will eliminate the T. So I don't want to do that. See, I don't want Rick or treat. I want trick or treat. So what I need to do for this is I need to go over to shapes, choosing a square because it has a flat edge. And what we're going to do is slice this out. Slice out our bat. I'm changing the square so that it's just going to cover that. Now, you want to get real close because you don't want, like, the T to have, like, a little bit on there. And if it helps, you can use your little magnifying glass over here or the plus or minus type of thing because you don't want to cut off too much of the letter either, okay? So this is what we're doing. I think that looks pretty good. So now I'm going to select both the trick-or-treat and the box, and I'm going to come down here to slice, okay? So slice, remember, works like cutting cookie dough with a cookie cutter. It basically gives you all these pieces left over. We don't need this bat, so we're just going to get rid of it. That was just a way to get rid of it. But now I want to separate this out because I want my letters to be big, and except for the or, I want to be small. So I'm going to again choose a shape, and I am just going to cover the trick part of trick or treat, select them both, also do slice. All right. And now you will see trick is independent of or treat. Now we're going to do that same thing again. Shape, square, put it over the or, do this, slice, and now our or and our treat are independent. This is important for us because I want to make this or a little bit smaller. So these letters, as they come in, are about 1.6 inches. So I'm thinking maybe just 1 inch. Sorry, guys, about the dog. So I'm thinking maybe just 1 inch, trick or treat. This also solves a problem for us by cutting it up. It solves a problem for us when we go to actually cut this out of vinyl, which will allow you to create even bigger banners that you want. I think I used approximately a 4-inch banner, 4-inch wide banner, because we originally designed this for the Joy. And guess what? You can do this on the Joy at this size. And so you can just go ahead and resize it to 4. But then I'm going to duplicate it, and I'm also going to resize it down to 2 inches as well. And once I have those, I am going to take this whole bit and I'm going to duplicate this as well because I want to make them sized for my images. So this is the kind of thing you're going to do. You're just going to take your one word and sort of see if the sizing is right. I think it should be a little bit bigger. So I'm going to group them together. Remember, this is important to group them together. And I'm just going to make them bigger just by pulling on the arrows, okay? But that's just a little, you know. Whatever. I kind of like the letter being in all three colors, but just barely. You know what I mean? So that's the size. They ended up being about 2 inches high for the 4-inch ones. And let's resize these ones for our smaller ones. Maybe I'll make them 1 inch high, 1.2. Let's see if 1.2 works. Yeah, 1.2. Now look at the or. It's not, it's like 0.75. Okay. So it's going to go on one of these candy corns. And then all that's left to do is for you to duplicate the candy corn to, there's 10. Basically letters, or is 2 letters, but there's 10. So you're just going to come up here and do duplicate 9 more times, okay? And for this, you're going to do the same thing down here, do this and duplicate it 9 times like this. And my computer, I think I need to get a new computer, guys. It's so sluggish. I have so many videos and images on it, and I'm having such a hard time with it being just sluggish. So anyway, so when you go to create this, if you're going to do it in both sizes, what I would suggest is you group them together and you cut them separately. It's just will make your life easier when you're going to put it together, but that might be my brain. So you do you, whatever you want to do. Okay. So then when you go to cut it, now I only have 6 on here. I need to go back and add more. Hold on. So we're going to ungroup this, and I'm going to duplicate this a few more times. All right. Okay. So the thing I want to show you about cutting, first of all, this is going to be cut on vinyl, and you can put the ore anywhere you want. We cut it out on glossy black vinyl because I have so much of it. So we're going to cut that on glossy black vinyl. But these ones here, you see all this wasted space, and I'm going to be using craft board. So what I want to do here is I want to start economizing the space. So I'm going to turn some of these over like this, and I'm going to move these to... So there is another one, and I think I can get 6 at this size. So I only need to use 2 sheets rather than 3 sheets of craft board. If you want to try squeezing more onto the page, you can do that as well. And the same thing holds true here for the orange. If you start playing around, you can economize your use. And I'll tell you something, orange is tricky. I have orange cardstock, and it's like there's 5 different shades of it. It's so crazy. I have like pumpkin, carrot, asparagus. I don't know. It's all like all vegetables, but I have a lot of these, and I just... What happens is I don't want to use, I have it in 12 by 12, so I want to use that. So I have to kind of economize, and you can tell the difference if you're cutting it from 2 different pieces of paper with orange. I don't know, for some reason, orange is a funny color in design space. I mean, sorry, in paper crafting. It's a weird color. I don't know. So there's like a muted orange, and then there's a bright orange. It's like a neon orange and all of that. So you can do that thing. On the yellow pieces, they all fit really comfortably, so you can cut them out with an 8.5 by 11. So let's move down to my work surface. I'm going to show you a few little tricks that I've learned along the way. So in terms of the letters... Here's what happened. Here's what it cut out. And I basically just cut it out by the okay, you guys, by the word itself, and put the vinyl on there. Now, these ones here, I just did a regular weeding of it before I put the vinyl on it. And let me see if I can find my weeding tool. Here it is. Yeah. But I wanted to show you a little trick. Get it? Trick. I wanted to show you a little trick in case you're worried about working with vinyl. This is called reverse weeding. So what I did was before I weeded, so see that? I did not weed it, but I did cut it out. So before I weeded, I just put the tape over there, the transfer tape over there. And yes, I did use my scraper, and I went like this, okay? But it's on the entire thing. So then what we're going to do, lift it up, and we are going to take off the backing, just like this. And now we are going to weed it while it's on the tape. And this is a great way. Hey, you guys, this is a great way if you're concerned about letters falling off or not sticking to your transfer tape. Okay, it does require a little bit more tugging, but you can handle it. Okay, so here we go, and I am weeding this like this. You still have to get in there with your weeding tool after the fact, but here you go. So if you're afraid of using all that vinyl you happen to accumulate with your mystery boxes, this, you have no more excuses. You need to start using your vinyl. Or maybe you bought it in bulk like I did. I bought a ton on bulk on clearance. And by the way, there's a huge sale going on right now. And it might be beneficial for you to go over and check it out. Plus, anything on sale, you're going to get 10% off if you have access, or 10 or 20% depending on your access and if it's a material. I know it's a little confusing, but plus if you use my link and my code, which I really appreciate when you do that, you get 10% off as well. My link and code work together. And here is Trick Or. Okay. Now, the thing that's a little bit fussy about this is that you might not be ready to put it on somewhere. So I would keep that backing and just sort of put it on there. Okay. Now, as far as the little banner is concerned, see, this is the one that I did with paper, and this is the one I did with craft board, which I like much better. So it's a pretty easy peasy project. You're just going to match these up where they belong. It's pretty hard to get this wrong, and we're going to glue each piece. It doesn't matter that this has a sticker on the back, but you could remove it if you wanted to. And we're going to just match them up. Make sure they're all matched up. And we got the yellow. So you're going to do this 10 times. I'm not going to do 10 times. But you're going to do this 10 times until you have 10 candy corns. Okay? So that's what you're going to do. Now, we're going to do the vinyl on here. There are two ways you could do this. One is you could keep these letters on the same, like you could either cut them out individually, which is what I tend to do. I tend to just like cut them out individually and then put them on the letters. Or if you are really like, a pro at this, you could actually just peel back the layer that you want, provided that they're all coming off. What I would do is take the backing off here. Hello, come on, backing. Just like this. Make sure that it's sticking, which it's not. All right. Peel back the backing like this. Like this, you know? And you can then put it on your, either way, I think this might help you line it up better. So if you're not so good at keeping letters the same, this will work really well for you. So here I did the R, and I'm going to do the I. It kind of helps with your, I don't know, with your, when you're eyeballing it. Okay, C is coming next. I want to get it on all three colors, a little bit on yellow, orange, and white. I just think it looks better that way. Oops. So there's that, and the last one. By the way, you can reuse this transfer tape, the Cricut brand. You can reuse it. So if you're worried about waste, I often will reuse it on projects, especially for the videos, okay? And yes, it works great on paper, but what you don't want to do is really press it down, because sometimes your paper is not like this. This is textured paper. It's actually Cricut textured paper here, and that's the craft board. Sometimes if you're using like a smooth paper like this one is, it might lift. It might lift, and you don't want that to happen. So you really, really just want to press down where the letter's going to be. And sometimes when it lifts, you can sort of repair it, but you can always kind of see it. I've had it happen to me. It happens to the best of us. But see how I'm not pressing down on there? I'm just pressing where the letter is, and then I'm quickly taking this up. That's the other thing. Don't leave it on and come back to it, even if, you know, there's a pot boiling on your stove, because then sometimes you'd have the same problem even with the textured paper. Okay? So there's our T-R-I-C-K. There's Trick. And then we have here our Ore Treat. Oh, wrong one. This is the small one. That wouldn't look good, very good. Trick Ore Treat. Turn it on the back. Remove this. Okay, Trick Or now it's smaller, so it's going to just fit into the orange piece. And I like that look. If you don't, you don't have to do the smaller ones. You can make it the same size as the other ones. But this is my project, so this is what I'm doing. All right, so let's do the rest of the treat with this. Let's flip it over and just take off one letter at a time. I think this is probably the better way to do it, but it's up to you. Whatever you want to do. Also, do note that I did not use a font. I did not use a text box. I used an image. A lot of times people think you have to, you know, reinvent the wheel. Honestly, you don't. You can go ahead and look for images. And if it's not what you want, you can manipulate those images where you can take something out. I do this all the time. And there's nothing wrong with doing that. You know, it's just their images, especially if you're a Cricut Access customer, they're images that are there for you to use any way you like. Yesterday, I had a brand new product expert, Angela C. So shout out to Angela. So I had a brand new product expert ask me, I didn't make 10 of these. What? Okay. So ask me about like making things and selling them with Design Space. You absolutely can. I just put this A on totally crooked because I was so concerned about, what should I do about that? Nobody will notice, but yeah, see, I don't think I can lift it. All right, so it's a little crooked. All right, so it looks like we have Trick or Tree. There's no T. I'll have to go back and make that, but here's the T. I don't know. What did I do? So, now we want to string them up and go ahead and put your line, your images. Wait, Trick. You can spell Rita. C. Trick. So Trick or Treat. Okay. Now I'm going to get my baker's twine. This is baker's twine I got forever ago at a place called Pick Your Plum. I don't even know if they're around, but I got it like in every color, and I have like oodles and oodles. Oh, I need 11 and I only made 10. Thank you. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Ah, there you go. I'll go back and make the last one so it doesn't say trick or tree. Okay, so this is called Baker's Twine. You can buy it at any craft store. It's probably going to be priced higher. This stuff is cheap. And it's cheap to make, so look for opportunities to buy it in large quantities, and you will save yourself money in the long run. So what I like about this one, it's black, and it's twisted black, so it's kind of cool. And let's see, I'm just going to take off a length of it. And again, it will last you forever. Just going to take off a length of it. Now, unfortunately, because this is twisted like this, it does unravel. So I use if any knitters are out there, this is what I use. It's a knitting sewing needle. It's got a big head. It's not a hard thing to get, and you can get that at a craft store as well. And I just do that. And then what I do is I start from, let's see, do I start from the front or the back? I start from the front. And I just pretend like I'm sewing. I put it down into the hole because I don't want it over here. It will mess up my image. And then I pull it almost to the end, leave a little tail there. And then I do the same. Whoops, go in this way. Now, you might have seen my other craft haul video, and I got this crocodile, but which uses like eyelets. But once I found this, look what I just did. I used a blanket stitch, accidentally used a blanket stitch here. Whoops. Okay. Just have to untangle this. Well, so I wasn't able to get my crocodile to work the way I wanted it to. And then I found this image with the holes in it, and I was like, saves me the headache of trying to learn how to use it. But I will use it in the future. I will figure out how to use it in the future. But then you just are going to go through this and do it this way, just like this. Okay, so trick. Now, I am doing this for two purposes. I'm doing this big one for above my door. So when the trick-or-treaters come, it's going to have this big, you know, swooping banner, trick-or-treat. But you know that on Sunday, we're going over to create an escape. So I wanted, and we're doing tiered trays. So I wanted to have something to put on the tray. And I thought this would look really cute at this size on my tray. And so I did these separately like this. And honestly, guys, this is all there's to it. Trick or treat. Is that fun? Did you like it? Wow, we have 82 people on. Hey, if you're new, introduce yourself, because we love new people, and this is the friendliest group on the internet. And also, if you're new and you're just logging in, remember these important things. Tomorrow's Christmas Day. We're doing this card with a vinyl inscription. And on Friday is Freebie Friday. We're doing the Dreaming Tree Gobble Gobble card. And then on Saturday for date night, which is at 5 o'clock, is our Laurie Whitlock Haunted Mansions or Haunted House. On Sunday at 10 o'clock, we're live from Create and Escape, where we'll be doing the tiered trays. Remember, if you like what you have seen today, or if you're new, whatever, please, please, please help me by telling people about it. I love it when you guys talk about me. I know, is that totally vain? I don't know if it's totally vain, but it just feels really, really cool to show up. And I'm in it to win it at this point. When I first started this, I was just doing it to pass the time for the pandemic, but now I'm like in it to win it sort of thing. And so I love, love, love when you share. And again, remember, I'll be back later today. I don't know what time, but I'll be back later today to show you my craft haul from Michaels. It's really a paper haul from Michaels and Craft Direct. So definitely come to check that out, or I'll post it on YouTube. All right, everybody, that's it for today. I got all that stuff in 45 minutes, and I did talk fast. I hope I didn't bore anyone. We'll see you again tomorrow, and love you all. Love you, and hope to see you again really soon. Take care, everyone. Bye. Oh, Shirley, good luck on the root canal, and also congratulations to Dorothy Martin, who is from Canada. I think she's from Nova Scotia, who got married in August and didn't tell any of us, or maybe she told you guys, but I didn't know. Congratulations, Dorothy Martin. So happy for you. And good luck, Cheryl, on that. Hi, Noane. And also, welcome to our UK followers, because we seem to be getting more and more UK followers, and that's great, because I think because we do this in the morning, they can get on the live because it's now afternoon for them. Okay, all right, everyone, see you tomorrow. Oh, actually, see you in a little bit when I do the craft haul. Have a great day, everyone. Bye.